ending crime in a nation, you can't do that. This country virtually had no crime under the rule of the enlightened kings, and when we were in good stead with the Lord. What is the key to ending crime? Well, the key to ending crime, would you believe it, is trees and plants and animals. Freak! No, we're not a freak. We know what I'm talking about. Muppets. Oi. There's a book that's after being removed from the Bible, but you can get your hands on it now. It's called the Book of Jubilees. And the Jubilees tells you about all the spirits that are over the trees. The Lord says, my angels are spirits. And his ministers are flames of fire. So the more trees you plant, the more angels you have to fight the spirit of addiction, the spirit of alcoholism, the spirit of whatever violence that's in the cities. The less trees in the cities, the more violent, unruly, lawless, disease-ridden, stinky, stanky, sticky, wicky, pingy, pongy. I don't know. Mingy, mongy. You get. The rabbits told me to tell you that. Honest, they did. I was just about to walk up there and look. See me rabbits, you don't run away. Oh, I will hoose them at you. Rabbits, a ton ton! See? Don't mess with the ferocious rabbits. Oh yeah, I was halfway up the fucking hill. That one there told me to go back down and get the phone. And tell them fucking retarded bastards. Up the top. Up there. That. In order to end violence in the country, you need to move out of POW camps. You don't actually have to move out of them all the way. But when I was being instructed by someone in the past, they said that you have to turn a substantial portion of what is now called Dublin into a garden. That doesn't make any sense. That's what millions. Of course it's what millions. That's how you keep a system running. The system that the Lord commanded the popes and stuff like that to impose over you because of the sins of your forefathers. Well, now he's instructed me and the Pope to give you some stuff, some information to help those who want to be helped. Some people are just no fucking helping them. Well, all things are possible through Jesus, you know. But the wine look like fucking Jesus to you. Look at this big ugly mug. This is not a Jesus mug. This is a Jesus mug. I am a Jesus' mug. I'm a slave. Yeah. His yoke is light. Tell you how new yoke. So basically what you need is you need to plant more trees. See, this should be something that the coppers should be involved in. You know? But certain coppers, there's no fucking way that they want less crime. They want more crime, more house burglaries, more madness, so they get more funds, more backhanders, and more corruption. How fucking dare them? Anyhow, tweez. You know when you're out on the countryside, there's a lot less violence. Everything seems a lot more peaceful. Why do you think that is? Because all around you, outside your five senses, because that's all you can see is four, that's all you have is five senses, outside of light that you can pick up now, the senses, the energy, that's the light, outside the peripheral vision, just outside it, is spirits battling constantly, the good fighting off the evil. How do you access this? Well, what you have to do really is you have to, most importantly, say your Our Father in the morning. Keep your prayers short. You waffle God. He doesn't like being waffled. Believe me when I tell you, there's one thing God the Father hates, and that's you waffling him. Oh, it flicks your mouth. Ah! I already know this. Why are you saying it twice? No, I don't know. That's not a God impression. That's just me acting a prick. But that's what it's like. You just say one prayer and they say, "I want keep it short and sweet." And then he's reading your heart for the rest of the day. Don't bug the shit out of him. You know? Don't keep saying the same thing over and over again. He knows already what you're saying. He's all-knowing, all-present, and omnipotent, if that's the right word. Sounds like a good one. And he's more than that as well. But trees. That's what you need. You need trees. Because you pick the book up. You get the Book of Jubilees on audio on YouTube, yeah? And you listen to the audio of the Book of Jubilees. And I won't be long into it, and I'll tell you the names of the angels, the spirits that are in the forests and the woods. So you notice that rundown areas, they don't have many trees. They don't have many things like that. They seem to be more violent. There's an empty, dead feeling in it because they're surrounded by the spirits of the dead. That's why. You find out that if you go into the cities, you'll find all the cesspools. Fucking... Well, I was watching a documentary about people that were into vampirism in Dublin. You know what I mean? All sorts of stuff like that. Fists and arses, of course, they like to do that, yeah. I wonder where that... There's one gaff in particular where I hear all these stories. I know a lot of people that go in and out of these places. It's called the George. And they do lots of strange, freaky shit in there, by all accounts. Now, I was thinking... One of my girlfriends hangs around with loads of homosexuals. And I've been finding it difficult since I came to this town to get my willy into women. That's why I don't like the Irish women, I can't stand them. They get me tits, horrible little cunts that they are. I've been finding it hard to stick my willy in women in this town. And then, because I got kept getting cock blocked by homosexuals. And then I was thinking, it better not be a conspiracy with that girl of mine to stop me when she knows quite well that I have to produce sons. How dare they interfere with the Lord's work? But you know, I suppose I'm not saying it, but it could be. Women are very conniving. That's why I had to keep it around them. And that's why you have to rule over them. That's why Jesus makes sure he says you rule over them. This is another thing. If you don't rule over your woman in your house, God will punish you and take her away, because he hates to see a man being ruled. He doesn't like to see a man being ruled over by a woman. He'll think, right, that's enough, I can't look at this anymore. And the marriage will probably fall apart. The kids will be homeless. The kids will be daddyless or something like that. Mammy be out there calling in the boys in blue. She'll have the arse cocked in the air for all the attention she's getting off them when she's gone through the menopause. Or just maybe looking for a bit of dicky. Maybe daddy's dicky won't work for her anymore because she's been battering herself around the bedroom. What a big deal that she bought in one of those lusty sex shops that you find in the city where a lot of homosexuals and other pervy types congregate, you know? Yeah, if they get bored with fisting one another's a-holes and shit like that. Anyway, that's why there's lots of lusty spirits in the cities. Yeah? And they don't read the Psalms. So, if I was to walk into a gay bar one night, and it was only full of women, looking for the hole. It's a crooked place, it's bent, where all the benders are. Yeah, waiting for me to come in to bang a few of them. Jesus would fly in there before me and make that crooked place straight. Right, girls. He goes before me and makes the crooked places straight. Bent is crooked, isn't it?